That got him sort of some international notoriety, and people began to take notice in other places. And the first place that came up was the Just for Laughs Comedy Festival in Montreal. And it's the largest comedy festival in the world. And Bill went up there the first year when he went up there, was just as any other comedian, where I think he had like a 5 or 7 or 10 or 15 minute spot on some show up there in one of the clubs. And it was from that that producers really liked what they saw and wanted him back the next year to have the signature show, the one-man show at the Just for Laughs Comedy Festival. This was a huge coup, and that's what was filmed and then became Relentless. Pay very close attention at the very end when it ends and Bill is walking off stage, because back when Bill was getting ready to do that show, he contacted me and asked if I'd help him pick out the music for it. He always liked to have intro music when he came out on stage. And so the song that Bill picked for the intro and the exit to that show was Tomorrow Never Knows by the Beatles. And but when the DVD came out, they were not able to get the licensing rights for those songs. So at the very end of the show, you will, as Bill's leaving the stage, you'll see him stop and he points up and mouths the Beatles, because that's what the people in the original audience that night were hearing. It being in Montreal, and this was Bill's first visit to Canada, he thought it was going to be cold up there. So he has on a jacket and a black turtleneck sweater, and the sweat is just pouring off him during the entire show. So he realized when it was over, he had dressed wrong for that.
So I'm up here and it's Canada, and I'm thinking, you know, Canada, cold. Huskies, you know, and I'm wearing, if you notice, the black cotton fucking turtleneck. Because, ladies and gentlemen, apparently summertime means the same thing even in the French provinces.
That went so well, and it was so well received, that then the same producer and director of that show wanted to film another one of Bill in England the next year. And that was filmed at a 2,500 seat theater, sold out, packed 3 deep apparently, at the Dominion Theater in London. And that show became Revelations. Bill, throughout his whole career, off and on would go back and touch Elvis. And sometimes he would come out dressed as Elvis and do a routine. And sometimes he would come out and talk a lot about Charlie Hodge, who was the man that brought Elvis his scarves and his water.
So what else, man? What was the last thing you said there before you died?
Before I died? Oh, I remember it was very confusing thing. I went in there to take my daily constitution, which takes up to 3 or 4 days to do it. I call it my weekly constitutional. I changed the whole name around just so it would fit more or less my first. See, my last words were right toilet paper, and then I said, man, I don't remember the floor being that close. And then I woke up here, man, and Jerry Lee Lewis was going to get used to it.
What are the famous people? Rock and roll people do you have up there?
Well, strangely enough, it's just me and Jerry Lee.